Good morning, students of class 9. You are welcome back to the e-classes now. We are doing socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. We have reached 1.4 support for socialism. So now, first we'll talk about socialism, then later on we'll talk about Russian Revolution. Right now we are talking about socialism in Europe. So now here, there are altogether 7 points over here. Number one, go through it. Listen carefully and we'll go through it one by one. Listen carefully. By 1870, socialist ideas spread through Europe. The idea of socialism spread through Europe from one country to another, from there to another. It spread all over Europe. To coordinate means work together. To coordinate their effort, socialists formed an international body. They formed an international body. So, means the socialists from various countries, they united and formed a body. And this is known as Second International. This is also called Second International. Now here, number two, workers in England. So let's talk about various countries. In those countries, what socialists they did. So, workers in England and Germany, they began by forming associations, they formed associations, groups, organizations to fight for better living. They fight for better living and working conditions. Working conditions to improve working condition as well as better wages, short reduction in working hours and so many. They united themselves and formed an organization in various countries, and all organizations around Europe were connected. Number three, these workers, the workers in France, the workers in Germany, the workers in Britain and other areas, these workers set up funds. They set up funds, they grouped together, they united together and formed funds to help their members, working members, such as factory workers. The factory workers contribute some money every time they get the payment, and the fund used to be used to help their members in time of distress. Distress means during the time of trouble. If any member of the working class or the of the association, if they need some money for various purposes at home, for marriage, and for other purposes, see, these funds will help them. So they demanded a reduction of working hours. These workers, socialist workers, they demanded the reduction of working hours and right to vote and increment of wages they demanded towards the industrialists. They demanded to the industrialists and other landlords and big farmers, traders. In Germany, not only England and other areas, in Germany also these associations worked closely with Social Democratic Party. In Germany there was Social Democratic Party, and these associations, the people of these associations worked closely together and helped to win parliamentary seats. This Socialist Party, the member of the Socialist Party helped the Democratic Socialist Party to win the seats in the parliament, German parliament. In this way, in Britain also, by 1905, socialists and trade unions, they combined together, united themselves and formed a labor party. Where socialist, 1905, in Britain, socialist and trade unions. A socialist comes under peasants, small farmers, workers, factory workers. So socialists and trade unions, businessman union, formed a labor party. In America and England, they formed labor party. In France also they formed socialist party. So you see there in various countries they formed the parties, they formed groups, organization, associations, and various parties they formed. In this way socialism spread all over Europe. However, till 1914, when the First World War began in 1914, till then, till 1914, socialists never succeeded in forming a government in Europe. They never succeeded in forming a government there in Europe till 1914. Now next, number 7, represented by strong figures in parliamentary politics, because now they form parties and slowly these parties became a political party and they supported the other members of the parliament and represented by strong figure in the parliament politics, parliamentary politics. Their ideas, socialist ideas, their ideas did shape, their ideas shape legislation. Legislation means making laws, forming the laws. Their ideas reshaped the making of the laws in European countries. But the governments all around Europe, but the governments continued to be run by conservatives, liberals and radicals. Various groups, they began to rule the country, but socialists, they never managed to form a government till 1914. So this is all about socialism in Europe. Now we'll talk about Russian Revolution. Now here comes the Russian Revolution. So far we have learned about socialism in Europe. Now next class we'll have 2.0. You go through that in the book also, or each subtitle you go through it. Not all at a time, one subtitle you go through every time. 2.0, we'll talk about the Russian Revolution in our next class. So till then you go through this online class as well as you go through the book, so that it will become more clear to you. So reading is also very important. So Russian Revolution will continue. Thank you for watching your video and we'll meet in the next class. Stay safe. Keep on studying at home. Whatever is being provided materials, you go through it, practice, learn at home. That's all for today. Thank you very much.